If I asked you how many dollar bills are in this stack, you probably wouldn't care. But if I told you you could keep it if you guessed how many there are, well then you'd want to count it. And you'd probably count it something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it turns out this is a really good way to count. For example, if we wanted to count the number of numbers in this list, well obviously there are 20 numbers from 1 up to 20. And we can see that because if the stack had $20 bills, well, we'd count it just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. But what if we had a list of numbers that started somewhere other than 1, started at a higher number? How would we count the number of numbers in that list? Let's take a look at that. And no, there aren't 20 bills in this stack, so I'm going to keep the dollar bills. And now we're going to look at a list that starts with 73. And goes up by 1 each time, 74, 75, and so on, up to, say, 121. How will we count how many numbers are in this list? Now, we could just list them all out, write in every single number, and then just count them off, 1, 2, 3. But that would take a very long time. However, that 1, 2, 3 gives us an idea. If we can turn this list that we don't know how to count easily into a list we know how to count easily, well, then we'll be pretty happy. And we know how to count lists that start with 1. So let's make this list start with 1. We'll subtract 72 from 73, and that gives us 1. And let's see what happens when we do that to each of the other numbers in the list. And we get 2, and then we get 3. And sure enough, we get 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to, we subtract 72 from the last number in the list, and we have 49. And clearly there are 49 numbers from 1 to 49, so there are 49 numbers in this last list. Subtracting 72 from every number in this list doesn't change how many numbers are in that list, so because there are 49 numbers down here, there have to be 49 numbers up here. So it looks like we know how to handle lists in which all the numbers are whole numbers, and we're going up by 1 each time. What about lists in which the numbers aren't whole numbers? Worse yet, what if some of the numbers are negative? So to check that out, we'll make a list starting from negative 1.3. Go up 1, we get negative 0.3. Go up 1, we'll end up in positive numbers. And say we keep on going all the way up to 201.7. Well, again, we could list them out, but that would take a long time, and it would be pretty tough to count them all once we had them all listed. Instead, let's do the same thing we did last time. Try to make a list that starts from 1 and goes up 1 each time. To turn negative 1.3 into 1, we just add 2.3. And we get 1. And look what happens if we do the same thing to each of the other numbers. Sure enough, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. And then the last number in our list, when we add 2.3 to 201.7, we'll get 204. And since obviously there are 204 numbers in this list, there are 204 numbers in this list as well. So it turns out this was essentially the same problem as starting from 73. We solved it with the same method. So now we see that our method works for any whole numbers. It works for negative numbers. It works for numbers that aren't whole numbers. Maybe we can use this to make a formula. Since we think it'll work for any number, we'll start with any number. We'll call it A. And this can be anything. It can be 1, it can be 7, 73, it could be the square root of 2. And we go up by 1 each time. A plus 1, A plus 2. And we'll keep on going until we get to some number. We'll call that B. And we want to find a formula for how many numbers are in this list. Well, we'll do the same thing we did in all the other problems. We'll turn it into a list that starts at 1. To turn A into 1, we just subtract 1 less than A. And that gives us 1. And sure enough, when we subtract this from the next number in the list, this one's 2 more than that, we get 2. And if we just keep on going, we get exactly what we expected to get. 1, 2, 3, 4, but where does it end? Let's see what happens when we subtract A minus 1 from B. We'll have B minus A, and then minus a negative is a positive 1. math is one of the few places where two wrongs does make a right. And we see that our list goes from 1 up to b minus a plus 1. And now we have our formula that we could use on any of these lists. But now that we have the formula, we'll realize, well, we don't need this formula at all. If we really understand what we're doing here, all we're ever doing is turning a list that goes up by 1 each time into a list that goes 1, 2, 3. So each time, all we're doing is taking 1 less than the first number and subtracting it from the last number to turn it into this list. And even more important than this is seeing what our general strategy has been all along is we take a complicated new problem that we're not sure how to do and just turn it into an easy problem that we've already solved. And once you've mastered doing this, take the next step. Instead of looking at lists that go up by 1 each time, look at lists that go up by 2 or 3 or 4, or go down by some number, go down by 4 each time, or even more challenging, go up by some fraction, a list that goes up 2/3 each time. Take a look at those, see if you can figure it out, because we're going to talk about them next.